Sri Tej Bharath Namburi, who kindly share his experience on the electronic passbook in Andhra Pradesh.
Good morning to everyone. I first thank the dignitaries on the dais and off the dais for giving me this opportunity. And I also thank the organizers of ILDC for calling us and making Government of Andhra Pradesh a partner to this program. My presentation is on e-title.com Pattadar Passbooks. My name is Tej Bharath. I am a deputy collector in the state of Andhra Pradesh, currently working in CCLA office. And to start with, revenue department, we are having the lectures since yesterday, different sessions, that revenue department is a land administration department, but dealing with many other departmental activities of civil supplies, elections, etc., etc. So only 15% of time is being spent on revenue activities, on core land administration activities. This is the first thing. And this is the revenue department profile of Andhra Pradesh. We have 13 revenue districts, and we have revenue divisions of 51 divisions are there, and revenue mandals 670 mandals, and revenue villages of about 17,000 odd villages are there. Total area of 160,000 square kilometers of area is there in Andhra Pradesh. Actually, I feel very proud to say that in past 2.5 years, lot of e-governance initiatives has taken place in revenue department in Andhra Pradesh. In yesterday's session, my friend has given a demonstration on Meembhoomi project, where all land records are kept in open and in a public URL, and anyone can access land records of anyone in the state. That is one of the important project. Our journey started with the land resource management system, where the total data has been entered in Excel sheet format of LRMS, and then later, as my senior has said earlier, we have a webland, which is our core database. The data has been ported into webland from LRMS, so which is the heart of our revenue department. After that, we have brought a project called Sarkar Bhumi. Sarkar Bhumi is a project to denote the all government lands, different type of waste lands, in a separate portal, and it will be easy for us to identify and protect those government land pastures. And later we have brought Miseva, which is a citizen service center. In Miseva, about 34 departments are giving the services to the citizens. Among that, revenue department is a major stakeholder. And we are providing about 62 services in Miseva through in the state for public. Then we have Aadhaar seeded all the 80 lakh, about 92% of Khatadars has been Aadhaar seeded in the webland. And we have taken a module for rectifying the errors in the revenue records called as rectification module. Then we have launched this Meembhoomi project. And then we have conducted a door-to-door campaign called Meembhoomi means your land in Telugu. And then we have conducted a campaign called Mee Intiki Meembhoomi. That means your land details at your doorstep. So we have delivered the land details of every Khatadar to every household, and we got acknowledgements that the land details are correct. And we have uploaded the acknowledgements. Then we finally got clarified that 98% of our record is pure. Then we have introduced the system of electronic passbooks, which I am going to present now. And we have also integrated webland with loan charge creation module, which is selected for National E-Governance Award in 2016-17. And we have also integrated with other 11 departments. This is the journey of revenue department. These are the initiatives. And to go to the electronic passbook, first I want to say 1 minute about Miseva, because if you don't understand the background, the functionality of electronic passbooks cannot be explained easily. Miseva is a citizen service center, government to G2C services, government to client services will be given using Miseva. In Miseva, as on 31st March 2017, about 8.6 crore transactions has been applications has been received, and among that about 6.8 crores of applications are related to revenue department alone. So out of 34 departments, imagine one department delivering services of 71% of total Miseva transactions. That is the volume of work being done in the revenue department. And we have two categories, category A and category B. Category A is the delivery of the output across the counter. Within 15 minutes, you can obtain the deliverable. Category B is, it needs some process, some inquiry, etc. Which will have some SLA period, statutory level agreement period. In that, we have to deliver the services. So, category A generally, the copies of Webland and Arangal, etc., they will ask for it. And these are the basic steps we have taken so far. Then computerization of Arangal is the very crucial thing. For conducting any mutation electronically, computerization of Arangal is must and should. Then we have also taken up scanning of RSR, FMBs and village maps also. So Tahsildars has been allotted to this duty, and they updated the data in for everything into Webland for the sake of conducting the mutations. So we have, this is the our Webland portal. In Webland portal, a application for mutation will be received in MeSeva. The same application with respect to land record will be going to Webland. So Tahsildar can directly access the application in Webland also, and he can also see it in MeSeva. Once he makes corresponding changes in the Webland portal, the automatically the changes gets updated in MeSeva, and the deliverable will be given to the client. So this is the integration between MeSeva and Webland, which is our core database. And one of the important duty in Webland is to conduct the mutations. So these are the Webland features: entry, updation of village names, Pattadars, processing of mutation requests, generation of electronic passbooks, loan charge creation, maintenance of government lands, and grievance handling mechanism. These are the Webland features. And another important feature is Aadhaar seeding. Now all departments are taking the activity of seeding the Aadhaar numbers to the stakeholders or the public records in the public records. This will benefit in identifying land ceilings cases, to authenticate the land details, and to identification of genuine Pattadars while issuing loans or crop subsidies, etc. And to capture phone numbers and bank account numbers of concerned Pattadars, so give them alerts, SMS, etc. So this is the process of Aadhaar seeding. Tahsildar will get the Aadhaar numbers entries directly from APSRDH, which is a state resource data hub where all Aadhaar numbers are stored. And from that, directly in Webland, Aadhaar seeding will be there. And in case where Aadhaar numbers taken are not matching with the Aadhaar numbers in SRDH, VRO, village level revenue officer, will go to the each Khatadar and will collect the Aadhaar numbers, and he will produce for seeding in the land records. So at present, we have 80.68 lakhs of Khatadars. Among that, 73.45 lakh Khatadars were seeded with their Aadhaar numbers in the Webland. And balance is 7.23 lakhs. In that, various cases are there, like their lands belonging to some institution where Aadhaar number is not possible, and NRI lands, and also there are some cannot be seeded cases are there. So these are different Aadhaar seeding. So this is the basic Webland structure. Now we are going to mutation service. So as per ROR Act 1971, Record of Rights Act 1971, column number 12 denotes the name of the owner, and column number 13 in the Arangal denotes the name of the enjoyer who is in the occupation. So we have two type of records which we give to public. One is called title deed and one is called Pattadar passbook. Pattadar passbook is the proof for occupation, and it is given by Tahsildar to the concerned farmer, and the title deed will be obtained from the RDO after his approval to give issue to farmer. There are two books initially. So we have different mutation applications. When this mutation happens is, whenever any land record is a record of dynamic nature, the owner will be always changing. There will be a lot of deaths, there will be a lot of registrations, new sales, partitions, and there will be succession, there will be gifted deeds. So the nature of the land owner will be keep changing in column number 12, and for this purpose we have introduced the mutation service. Mutation means change. So this service people will apply in the MeSeva along with the concerned proofs, and the documents will be scanned by MeSeva operator, and he will push the documents from MeSeva login, his MeSeva login, to Tahsildar's MeSeva login, and this will be accessed in the Webland also to verification of the documents. Everything is done online. Otherwise, In the earlier days, before Miseva and Webland, to get a Pattadar passbook, a farmer has to see hell. He has to visit the office many times. There is a lot of corruption and still there are a lot of mistakes. There is no timeline to deliver the passbook. There is a lot of problems are there. So IT is information technology is the only solution for all the questions. So by introducing this mutation come Pattadar passbook service electronically, by giving them, we gave it a SLA period of 30 days. Within 30 days, it will be delivered definitely. So we have created a system like that. We have trained everyone. We get intimations from three places. One is from Miseva, where the farmer himself will for a mutation. And second is from sub-register office. We have integrated registration database with Webland. So whenever any new transaction in under sale deed or gifted deed or partition deed takes place, from SRO login to MRO login, a Form 8 intimation will be sent. So this is second type of intimation. And third is village level revenue officer is also under statutory duty to bring into the Tahsildar's notice about any change in ownership in his jurisdiction. So these three type of intimations will be coming to Webland, and in this Webland we take process will be initiated to conduct the inquiry, and we will publish Form 8 notice in the villages, in the panchayat. We call for any objections for 15 days, which is a statutory waiting period. We cannot approve within 15 days. After 15 days, we can approve the mutation request. So for the mutation plus title deed cum passbook service, the charge for MISA is 35 rupees and charge for printing of passbook is 100 rupees, 135 rupees. Within 30 days, we have to deliver the passbook. And there are three type of passbooks, electronical we are giving to public. One is new Pattadar passbook, which means his name is already in the land record, but he has not got the passbook. Second is a duplicate passbook. That means he has lost the passbook. So he have to show some proofs that police verification certificate or paper clipping that my passbook is lost. Then he have to apply with 235 rupees in MISEVA. Then his passbook will be given to him in 7 days. And we have replacement. If the passbook is mutilated or it is damaged, etc., then he can also ask for a replacement passbook by handing over the previous old passbooks. So to do this exercise, we have conducted extensive workshops and trainings to VROs, village level officers, Tahsildars, computer operators, everyone in the state. Then we have also trained MISEVA operators, because generally Pattadar passbook shall be given only to agriculture lands. But MISEVA operators, due to lack of knowledge, they will also take applications for house sites, everything they will take. So we have to give training to them also. Then we have published some pamphlets and we have distributed in villages. We have set up some posters and flexis in the villages and districts in panchayat offices and MISEVA centers, etc. So that public has good knowledge about this service. So this is the process of mutation. So applicant will be going to MISEVA center. From MISEVA center, application will be transferred to Webland. Tahsildar will be logging into Webland and will access the mutation, and he will see the link document, CC, whatever the document submitted by the applicant in MISEVA center along with the checklist. He will see that, and Tahsildar will finally approve the mutation and e-passbook. Then after approval of e-passbook, the initial days there used to be given manual passbooks. Manual passbooks are like just Xerox. We can also do it. We can also replicate in some Xerox center or some normal printing press also. We can do that. Due to that, lot of fake Pattadar passbooks has been accumulated in the state. So to eliminate the fake Pattadar passbooks is a very hectic exercise. In one of the districts, they have caught 80,000 fake Pattadar passbooks along with the fake stamps of VROs, etc. In the state, it got a lot of sensation at that time. So we have eliminated all manual Pattadar passbooks. Only Pattadar passbooks which are signed electronically can be given to the client. And this is the e-Pattadar passbook which we are talking about. In this e-Pattadar passbook, there is 13 security features are there. We have 15-digit unique number given to each Pattadar. So if we have a doubt if it is either genuine or not, we can check it in MISEVA with this unique number, whether it is genuine or not. And we have the photograph of the farmer, which is taken from his Aadhaar database, so that it cannot be a wrong photo. Its sign is also there in the passbook front page. Then we have a security thread, which is in, we can see in 1,000 rupees notes or 2000 rupees notes. That security thread is there, and we have multicolor design. These 13 security features we have incorporated in this passbook, and this can be printed only in a security printing press which we have an agreement government of Andhra Pradesh. And the printing press is under obligation to print every passbook after approval within 7 days, and to deliver it directly to the address given by the farmer. It will not come to our office, so that the farmer again comes to office and wait for collecting his passbook. It will directly couriered to concerned farmer. This is one great satisfaction for the farmers of our revenue department. This is the first and second pages. Second pages also we can see the color pages. And this is our disposal percentage. As on 31st March, we have total 16,79,000 applications received. About that 16,34,000 were already we have disposed those applications, and remaining are within SLA and very few in beyond SLA. So these are different type of passbooks we have issued. Total around 19,72,804 passbook applications we have received. Among that, 19,25,653 passbooks are sent to the farmers. We have used information communication technology at all levels of this mutation plus passbook service. Application, generation of notices, publishing, approving passbooks, printing of passbook, tracking of status of passbook, SMS alerts to the citizen at every level. Your application is processed, your passbook is printed, it is dispatched, your passbook is coming to you. Every message will be going to the farmer. So he has lot of confidence over government. And these are the advantages of electronic passbook. Because there is digital signature, nobody can tamper it. And there is a unique number, there is a barcode. Recently we have introduced QR code in place of barcode also. This is the achievement of mutation plus e-passbook, and 100% of fake passbooks have been washed away, and 95% grievance has been reduced after introducing electronic passbooks. This is a great innovation. And recently we have amended the RVAR Act 1971 in 2016, which says that the data in electronic form, that is 1B record, which can be accessed through MeBhumi, shall be presumed to be true unless it is proved otherwise. So bankers, registration offices, agriculture offices, they shall not insist for producing of any Pattadar passbook or title deed before him. They shall believe that if 1B is correct, he should give all services. It is an act now. Earlier we used to use circulars and GOs. Now act has been amended. And however, if a farmer, because farmer will be confident only when three things happen. Land is under his possession. His name is in the land records of government. And a title is in his hand, whether it is real, officially useful or not. If he have a document with him in his house, he will feel very comfortable and he will be confident. So for this purpose, however, if it is not officially required for any government service, if the farmer asks, it is mandatory for revenue department to deliver Pattadar passbook and title to him. Now we have also merged the two books into one book to reduce one level of exercise. You know, it is called e-title deed cum Pattadar passbook. So only one book will be delivered, which serves the both the functions to this thing. And we also very recently, from February 1st, 2017, introduced a new module called auto mutation module. So due to various works, due to genuine reasons and sometimes due to various other unwanted reasons, mutation is pending beyond 30 days at the level of Tahsildar for his approval. So we have created a module from the date of generation of Form 8 notice, whether Tahsildar approves or not, the system itself will automatically approve the mutation. This is called auto mutation module. And in this auto mutation module, since last 2 months, about 10,000 applications were automatically approved by the system. And these are the two innovations in mutation plus e-passbook. And this is our core duty of maintaining land records and issuing titles to the public. So this is about electronic passbook cum title deed. Thank you.